I guess my particular kind of music I would call world fusion or global grooves. It's really incorporating all sorts of traditional musics from around the world, India, Africa, Bali, Japan, with contemporary electronic sounds and also the kind of dance music, because I've discovered that when you put some beats and you can add some rhythm and people can dance, you can introduce them to a whole other style of music, the classical Indian, for example, that might be challenging to sit down and listen to a raga, but if you can dance and have some Western music that you recognize, all of a sudden you can deliver 20 minutes of raga and people enjoy it, where they might not sit still for pure classical. And as we are in the West, living in such a global society in Canada where there are people from around the world, it just seems like the natural evolution of these different styles as they all come together. Electronic music has brought the tools, the laptops and the keyboards and the things, and that has also allowed the electronic musicians to have conversation and connect with world musicians who have been very proficient on their instruments since the beginning. And it's only just now that the electronic instruments have allowed artists to also be able to have some dialogue, not just a one-way conversation on top of something. Years ago when I was younger, my father always used to tell me, oh, you should be bringing some music from the home, old country. And I was like, I don't know, Dad, it's a little bit. And you know, to interestingly full circle now, that's exactly what I'm doing. I think it happened the first time I heard a Hari Prasad Chaurasia album, and I was just blown away and rediscovered the music of my roots, and it connected with me and it wrapped around my spine in a way that no other music did. And so that was just the beginning of then meeting a tabla player and meeting a bansuri player and, you know, finding some common ground where these people were also interested in maybe moving beyond the traditional music forms that they were in. And it just happened naturally. And I have to say, yeah, it's just connected to what moves me. On the West Coast, and as a DJ 10 years ago, 8 years ago, as I started playing music back around, I really discovered in the rural communities that people were into a lot more the acoustic sound and live bands. And so for me, that was the journey of beginning to find stuff that connected with that vibration, but also, you know, bringing what the dance music scene had, which for me as well, I found a lot of the electronic music just a little bit too hard and maybe fine in the peak of the night at a big rave, but not necessarily translating elsewhere. And for me, it was just a subconscious choice of what different sounds I was attracted to. And as I started fusing that with traditional world performances of bansuri and sitar and tabla, it was just a natural marriage. It's a meditation, you know, when someone is hypnotizing you, it's that steady repetition of the pendulum or whatever that opens. And I think that's the thing in electronic music that allows for another type of space to open up. And so when you contrast that repetition with the live flowing of the jazz style constantly changing, this juxtaposition really sets both at an even higher level somehow. Now I'm really connected with a lot of the gypsy music and following the gypsy sound as it originated in northern India and Rajasthan and moved across into the Europe and the Balkans and up. And, you know, it has such a jovial energy, but it's still connected with these musical forms of northern India. So yeah, I'm really connected to all this world instruments. They connect me to the ancestry of music in these traditions of music that are 5,000 and 6,000 years old somehow. And in our society where everything is so pop and disposable and immediate, it feels really good to connect the ancestry and bring that forward so that we don't forget those traditions in our disposable instant society.